Hi guys, as usual it's me, just a voiceover, and you're watching review machines. And it seems like a huge tank is coming here. Well, maybe not so huge, but nevertheless are very interesting. Let's go! Guys, this time we made a real tank, and now we are going to review it. It looks quite weird, but in fact it looks very similar to a real Soviet tank MT-25. It's a serious machine. It has a skid steering, electric turnable turret, the cannon controlled by a joystick, and many more. I will show you all the details now. And today we will not only review this tank, but also compare it with another tracked ATV, so this video is going to be exciting. Well, get comfortable, my friends, in our tank, it's time to begin. The base of the tank is the steel frame, covered with armor plates. The engine is mounted on the frame, in the rear its part. We have here the engine from an old car. It's carburetor, full cylinder, 60 horsepower engine with mechanical gearbox. The drive goes through the additional custom reducer to provide more torque. Try to guess what the tracks are from. In fact, it's a tire from a tractor. The wheels from a car are used as rollers. Each roller has two wheels and a special metal part mounted on the track. It goes between the wheels and keeps the track from coming off. And this gear is some kind of a friction clutch. I'll try to explain how it works. There is a rear axle with a locked differential. Then there are two brake discs mounted on each side of the axle. To engage the drive, you should push the lever, and the brake system on the wheel interlocks with the disc on the axle and starts rotating, and the track moves. Let's look what we have inside the tank. The view is provided by this small windscreen on the turret. There is a cannon over the windscreen. There are two levers to handle the tank, and the gearbox lever between the legs. Also, there are two pedals, throttle and the clutch, that's all. Well, and now I am looking forward to try it myself. Well, I am in. Firstly, let's press the power button on, and now we try a cold start. To move forward, we have to push the two levers simultaneously. To move faster, we just press a throttle pedal. But now I want to say a few words about the first impressions. Guys, if you have never driven a tank, you will be impressed by this thing. That's our soul special emotions. It's dark and tight inside, and you can see almost nothing. You are absolutely isolated from outside world, but you can feel the machine. The engine is right behind you, and you feel how it rotates. I think these emotions are very close to the emotions provided by a real tank driving. The steering is very sensitive due to the quite powerful motor and additional reducing gear, so we have a high torque here. That is why the machine is handled very neatly, even by the slight moving of the lever. Frankly speaking, it's not much harder to handle this machine than to drive a tank in a computer game. I think many of us like to play those games, right? But the tank is not only a transport, first of all, it's a combat machine, so let's stop for a while and find out what we have here about that stuff. The turret has an electric drive and controlled by a joystick. The control is very simple. To turn the turret, just to steer the joystick to a proper side. when we push or pull the joystick, the cannon moves higher or lower. And finally, I think you might guess what this red button is used for. As armor, we use a special airsoft shell. It's a plastic, so to speak, arrow with peas inside. Now let's load the shell on the cannon and try to fire it. Meantime, we want to compare our tank with a similar machine, the tracked ATV Cayman. I know, these machines were made for absolutely different purposes, but nevertheless, it's interesting to compare them. And first of all, let's do our favorite test, the drag racing. The both machines are on a start line and ready to go. So let's start.
There.
The both machines accelerate almost equally, but then Cayman ATV overtakes his opponent, and the tank seems not to like it, and he without any hesitation uses his cannon. The shells blows up, spreading peace all around, and hits Cayman. The crew of the ATV seems to be stunned by the peace blow, and our tank is finishing alone, winning this competition. While the opponent is recovering from the drag racing, let's do some kind of bottle cap challenge. A bit belatedly, I know it, but anyway. Well, actually, it was some kind of a joke. Cayman crew is alright. The airsoft shells are quite safe, so we are ready to proceed our trip now. By the way, our tank should be quite good at off-roading. Unfortunately, we don't have much dirt in this season, but the tank is really capable to get over serious obstacles, due to the wide tracks with aggressive tire tread. In fact, this machine is like a real tank. It can go off-roading, can hit the targets. But most important, it can provide you emotions of driving a real tank. Besides, many solutions in the construction are very unusual. It's the friction clutch, the tracks, the electric turret, and so on. I think DIY man can take some interesting ideas from this project. Meantime, we are moving on, and you may ask me, but why? For what purpose have you made such a complicated custom tank? Well, first of all, we wanted to have some fun, and we got it finally. But then, the owner of this tank is going to try to make some money with it. He is going to rent out this tank, and maybe to make some more tanks, and arrange a real tank battles. Just imagine, two teams, five tanks in each team, an interesting location, with some obstacles and various conditions. It would be the greatest fun we have ever had, but it would take huge money to put this plan into action and make this dream come true. Maybe at one time, who knows? And we are reaching the river. The Cayman ATV is an amphibious vehicle. It's able to proceed the moving as opposed to our tank, that is can't float, of course. But on the other hand, he can use his cannon, as we know, and he does it.
This is Chuki.
By the way, let's say a few words about the prices. Actually, it took about $4,000 to make this project. Guys, do you know some projects like this? Please post in the comments, it would be so interesting to see something similar. And now it's time to call it a day. Thanks for having this little trip with us. Please consider subscribing the channel if you like this video. Stay with us, it will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye.